Hello students, a very warm welcome to all my little and lovely atoms. How you guys are doing? Hope all of you are doing absolutely awesome and in a very good health. Please do let me know in the comment section. I am reading your comments from the past 2 minutes and trying to come live. Yep. Good evening. Good evening, Shreya. Hello, Harshita, Harleen, Prasoon. Someone kept his name as Burger 2020. Like special burger you are making or something. Yeah, great. Thank you, Ansh. Looking beautiful. Thank you, Satvik. Hello, AT ma'am. Hello, Ganesh. Hope you are good. Hi-fi, Ganesh. Hi-fi to all my students. And Harshal, after a long time, a big hi to you too. Thank you. Thank you, students. Ayush, Ansh, just tell this to your friends also, that if you want to revise a chapter in approximately 45 to 50 minutes, that's what is my target. It can be plus 5-10 minutes. But what are we going to do today, students? This is a mind map class. It's not like ma'am is going to tell the entire chapter. But what we will do, we'll revise the chapter. And today's name of the chapter is Acid, Spaces and Salt. With some quick tips, with some short tips, in more of like a summary manner. So in one short video in Umang series, I have taught you each and everything in detail. You can follow those videos for revision. There are plenty of students who are telling me that ma'am, with the help of those videos, it was like a great help and I revised the things before my pre-boards and I'll get so much of help. So students, please follow those videos, and with the help of videos, if you're like done with your syllabus and revising everything, you can have a quick revision. Like, okay, let me revise by seeing ma'am in, maybe 1.25x speed. Yes? So this will be helpful. Teach us in 11th also. Ganesh, I'll try my level best. Yes, Ansh, Flash is also here. So students, let's keep some target and we will move ahead. Let's see if we can hit 300 likes till the end of the session. Not a very big target. Do tell your friends that come and revise. So share this among your friends and definitely subscribe if you're new to this channel. And practical chemistry is important. Yes, Meera. And on 9th Hindi channel, I've started this series called as Practical Chemistry Series, where I am showing you all the practicals which is very much important to you. So please do, see all those videos. Yeah? All right. Okay, so let's start with the mind map of acid, bases, salt, students. Thumbs up. Hello, Vidhi. Hello, Ishika, Tapas, Archana, Sai. Cutie ma'am, thank you student, thank you so much. So let's go and let's hit it, let's revise each and everything right now. So the very first thing that you should know about the acid part, we'll discuss acid, then base and then salt. Is it all good? Yep, Sanika, Shiva, everyone, okay, all good. So the very first thing that you should know about salt, that salts are something that is very much corrosive in nature, and yep, there is a warning sign on it that don't touch it because it is very dangerous. You can harm yourself. It will be there. If it will be, fall into your skin, it will be black and it will be like very much hurtful, because it just acids take water from that skin and give exothermic reaction and give a burning sensation. It will burn your skin, maybe burn your clothes also. So acid has some common property. First of all, sovereign taste. Like ma'am, who tasted acid? Like we do taste so much of acids in our day-to-day life in terms of having it from plants and animals, right? When ant bite you, that releases an acid called as formic acid, and that's acid only. And when I talk about your plants, tomatoes, your grapes, your mangoes, there are so many gourds also, bitter gourds, and so many of substances are there. Coffee having some compounds that are having acid in nature. So acids have in general common property. Sour in taste, turn blue litmus to red, because this is a litmus test that my acid shows. Conduct solution, electricity in the solution. Can you tell me, students, how it can conduct electricity? I'm waiting for your response. Thank you, Arpita Bachir, that means a lot. Yes, Sakshi, see here. Hello. Mrinal, that is a quick revision session, not like a mentee session, okay? I'll bring mentee personally apart from this. Insta DP change key. Yes, Dipanshu, finally. Because of H positive ion. Yeah. When you have acid and pour it in water, like you're having a solution of acid with water, your ions will be free. Hydronium ions and the counterpart, like suppose that's HCl, hydrochloric acid. So you will get H ion and chloride ion. So H ion will be there surrounded by water because H ion is very small in size. Only nucleus of hydrogen, so water will come and acquire and surrounded it. So hydronium ion and chloride ion will be there if I talk about HCl. If I talk about sulfuric acid, H ion in form of hydronium ion and sulfate ion will be there. So ions will be free and free ion can conduct electricity. So they releases those ions into the solution. Right, students? This is super duper clear. Thank you, Kiran. Thank you. Acids are of two types, students. I hope there is no denying in this fact on the basis of the sources from which you get it. Acids are something we get from, nature, called as natural acid, and those are the acid also called as organic acid. The source is living, okay? And mineral acid is something that we get from non-living sources, like my minerals, my rocks. Natural acids are also called as organic acid, like acetic acid, vinegar, your formic acid we get from ant, my lactic acid, which is there in my grapes, unripe grapes, lactic acid will be there in the curd also. So these are organic acid, and mineral which we get from minerals like which we get from earth crust in general, like hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid and all. Mineral acids are strong in nature, and natural acid, organic acids are weak in nature. That's why we can have it in our day-to-day life. We can drink it, we can eat it in a way. Okay? Thank you, Sneha. Thank you, Sneha. All right, students, guys, like and share the video. Please, if you're enjoying the session, and it will be super fun and helpful and informative. Chemical properties of acids are very, very important, students, and definitely question will come from this topic. Definitely, definitely, definitely. Okay, so let's master this one also, that when my metal react with acid, we get salt and hydrogen. Let me help you with an example. Suppose I've taken magnesium as a metal and I put it in diluted hydrochloric acid. My metal is going to displace hydrogen. This is a displacement reaction only. You will get magnesium chloride along with hydrogen gas. Okay, so metal salt, magnesium chloride along with hydrogen gas. The property that is hydrogen gas will release and give you a pop sound. Pop, pop is very much important. We should say corrosive and not strong, right? Yes, Sanika, we will say corrosive acid. Strong and weak will be dependent that which acid we are taking. And metal carbonate and bicarbonate react in the same way with acid to give salt, water and CO2 gas. Metal carbonate, bicarbonate always react with the acid to give salt, water and CO2. Same, it's just the reactant taken and the product formed. Their number of moles can vary, but the product will be same. Salt, water, CO2. How will you detect CO2 gas? That's an important question. They can ask you a question in form of XYZ. Identify XYZ. Suppose there's a very good question that X is a substance that react with diluted sulfuric acid. Gave one of the substance as calcium sulfate along with the gas that extinguish the burning candle. Identify the gas, identify the substance. So that's calcium carbonate, because calcium carbonate with sulfuric acid will give what? Calcium carbonate with sulfuric acid will give what? Calcium sulfate, water and CO2. So calcium sulfate is possible when I'm having calcium salt, calcium compound. So calcium carbonate. Why carbonate? Because CO2 gas will be released. That is the gas that can burn the, that can extinguish the burning candle. So that will be the reaction. You got it? Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. And how acid will react with the bases? This is a reaction that you know from 7th class. What's it? 7th class. That acid combined with the base to give exothermic reaction. Energy will be released. because you get salt and water. And when you touch the beaker, it will be a little hot, like little amount of energy will be released too. Yes? Life a class 9th, very soon, Kartike, on 7th March, okay, 7:15. You can put a reminder, you can put a, what's so called it, like in your phone. Alright, Kartike, okay, let's talk about the base now. Bases are bitter in taste. Have you tasted bitter gourd? Oh, bitter, very much bitter. By mistake, did you like come across the situation that you know, the soap will go to your mouth and you're like, I never wanted to taste it, but yeah, now I know how the soap tasted. Bitter, right? And bases are the one that is soapy. Bases are the one generally take water from, you know, small amount of water, absorb water. When they take water, they give that soapy appearance. Yes? Pai lagu. Apoorva, my A square, all Ashirvad. Turn red litmus to blue because base turn blue, red litmus to blue. That's the property, that's the indicator test we can have. And bases are the one that gives hydroxyl ion. Yes or no? Hydroxyl ion. Oh my god, so many students face this situation. Hydroxyl ions. Yeah. All right. Exothermic and endothermic. Exothermic. Exo means outside. Exothermic means in which energy is released. Exo, releasing. Endo, inside. So endothermic, in which energy is absorbed. Exothermic, in which energy is released. If absorb, you write it on the reactant side. Reactant needed that. If I talk about exothermic, energy will be released. When you touch the beaker, it will be hot. Okay? College pass out. Sakshi, I did my graduation from KMC, Kirorimal College, DU, Delhi University. Yes? Okay. Thank you, Yash. Okay. So, let's talk about the type of bases, students. Bases are of the two type, in general, water soluble and water insoluble. What do I mean by water soluble and insoluble? Water soluble bases are called as alkalis. Alkalis are like the one that whenever we put it into water, they will be soluble in water. So, my sodium hydroxide, my potassium hydroxide are the one that is water soluble because this is something we get from alkali metals. Alkali metals, water soluble base, and there are so many bases which are water insoluble. Like when I talk about copper hydroxide, even calcium hydroxide, okay, aluminium hydroxide, there are so many substances still not dissolved in water. So alkali are only those bases which are water soluble. Bases has a big category and alkali is just a part of it. Just a part of it. Yes, Bhavi, you got it? I gave the definition. As I said, these will be mini charts only. You will get the entire explanation. You will get the entire each and every detail in the Umang video, one shot video, sprint video where we discussed questions a lot. Alkalis are water soluble bases. Okay. Now, property of bases, my metal can also react with the base to give salt and hydrogen gas. But the reaction of metal with bases are very, very rare because metal has the same property as base. So same property can't react with the base. Only those metal can react with the base which are amphoteric in nature. Okay, students, can anyone explain this to me, that what is amphoteric? Amphoteric. Yes, Ganesh, all bases are not alkali because alkali is just a part of it, which are water soluble bases. And how to remember that? First group, alkali metal give water soluble bases. That's it. One line you need to remember. Yes, Kuvar. Yes, Kuvar. Okay, so amphoteric metal, no one told me. No, Anirudh gave the answer. Amphoteric metals are those metals that follows dual property that can react with acid as well as bases. So when I talk about my metal, aluminium, zinc, they are amphoteric in nature. They can react with the base because they can have acidic property too, base acid. And reaction will be same. The way my metal react with acid to give salt and hydrogen, same way my few metal will react with the base to give salt and hydrogen. But name of the salt is a new level different. The name of the salt is sodium aluminate along with hydrogen gas. Okay, you can balance the reaction that I'm leaving on you guys. You can balance it. Very nice, very nice. Now let's come back to the next question. Base with non-metal oxide gives salt and water. Who will tell me the nature of non-metal oxide? Nature of non-metal oxide. Come on, come on, tell me. Nature. Again, college. Sakshi, Kirori Mal College, Delhi University. Acidic, wonderful. Non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. Suppose I'm taking an example, carbon dioxide. Non-metal oxide, let's prove acidic. How come? Because they react with the base. I'm taking a particular base, calcium hydroxide, just to show you a reaction. Base with non-metal oxide, as they are acid. Acid base gives salt and water. So you remember this reaction. A lime water turned milky in CO2. Same reaction. My acid base give salt, which is calcium carbonate, and water, H2O. CaCO2, one oxygen from here, CaCO3. I'm left with one oxygen and two hydrogen, so H2O. Pre-board, Priya, all the very best. I know you'll do good. Electron, proton, photon, everyone is blessing you. Wonderful. This reaction is like next level, super duper easy. How my acid is reacting with base? They'll always give salt and water. Right, students? They'll always give salt and water. My interest is lagging. My internet is lagging. Sanika, is it fine now? Tell me. Okay, maybe some issue. I just scolded my Wi-Fi Dada though in the afternoon also, and he's like, I did everything possible and now it will not, going to lag. So let's see. Last one is neutralization. Neutralization's one more example. Acid with metallic oxide will also give salt and water. Acid, metallic oxide is basic in nature. Okay. Acid basis salt in English channel. Yes, Hindi channel is already done. Acid with base, because metallic oxides are basic in nature, also give salt and water. Let me help with the example. Sodium oxide is one metal oxide. Okay, I put it with an acid HCl. Let's see what are we going to get. As base, acid, salt and water. How come? Sodium with chlorine, 2 NaCl. 2 hydrogen with 1 oxygen, H2O. So we got salt and water. Is this reaction also clear, students? All right, wonderful, wonderful. But now the question is how we are going to identify whether we get acid and base. So the solution is indicator, yes or no? Indicators are the one that definitely indicate something. They tell us whether the given substance is acid and base by giving a particular color, because they are dye. Dye impart its color, give different color in acid and base. We have natural indicator like my litmus, my red cabbage, my turmeric. Turmeric case is something that happened with everyone, happened with me a lot. I don't know about you guys. Tell me, is this something that happened with you guys as well? That turmeric, you are eating some curry, obviously they are having turmeric in that, and you're just eating it, and somehow it fell on your clothes and it gave that that yellowish color stain. And when you try to rub the soap, okay, let me just get rid of it. This was my favorite top or t-shirt. So when you try to rub it, it will turn reddish brown. What say? Happened? Been there, done that. So turmeric is something that gives that, that is actually that yellowish color substance. In acid remains same color, base it will give reddish brown color. Yes, people? Yes, students? Wonderful. Yes. Okay. Kumar is like, no, ma'am, I'm very sophisticated. That didn't happen with me. All right. And litmus, you already know that litmus is a purple color solution basically, and turn its color to red in acid and blue in base. The same happened with the red cabbage also. The best part is red cabbage, but actual color is purplish. I hope you have seen the cabbage. Olfactory indicator is the one that is related to sense of smell, especially for those people who are visually impaired. So their senses of, you know, smell is very strong. So with that smell, they can detect whether that is acid and base, because there are indicators which destroy their smell in acid or base. And generally the one we know in 10th class is the one they destroy their smell in bases. So we have onion extract, onion juice. Okay, very bad, but yeah, very helpful. Vanilla essence that you might have used in the cakes also, baking cakes and pancakes or whatsoever. So they destroy their smell and bases. You can identify that. Synthetic one, laboratory we had prepared. Phenolphthalein and methyl orange. Phenolphthalein is a colorless dye indicator that changes its color only in bases. It will turn blue. It will turn pink, magenta pink, very wonderful pink in base, not in acid at all. Okay, you can remember a trick, NCP. No change in the colorless solution in acid and pink in base. The way the pH is written, left side acid, in between neutral, right side base. So NCP, no change, colorless, pink. And methyl orange is having an orangish color, which is having its color red in the acid, yellow in the base. So again, pH, ROY, ROY. Red in acid, yellow in base, ROY. Yes, you'll remember ROY? Wonderful. Yes, Chinmay, clove is also an example of my olfactory indicator. First time on Vedantu Live, Joseph, very warm welcome. Now, the big part is how you'll talk about acid and base differentiation in terms of its concentration, in terms of its strength. So students, if I talk about strength, acid and base are of two types, strong acid or base, or weak acid and base. But do remember that my strong acid, weak base is totally different from concentrated acid and diluted acid. Strong acid means that dissociate completely. Okay, students, will you remember this part? Dissociate almost completely. And weak means dissociate partially. Means when I'm having my strong acid like HCl and putting some drop of water, it will almost completely dissociate to make all the hydronium ions free. More and more hydronium ion, more and more strong your acid is. Weak, not going to dissociate completely. Like I'm having my acetic acid. Acetic acid is your this one. Acetic acid. When you are having its solution in water, it will dissociate to give acetate ion and hydrogen ion. This is acetate, this is hydrogen. And not going to dissociate completely means less amount of H ion. And again, it's still there in the form of molecule. Suppose I'm having 100 molecule, maybe 40 will dissociate to give H ion, 60 will be still there in the molecule form. So that's a weak acid. Okay. But how it's different from concentrated and diluted? Concentrated acid is the one that's having more amount of acid in your given solvent. And diluted acid is the one that's having more amount of water or more amount of solvent and less amount of acid. And we can make our concentrated acid dilute by putting required solvent into it. But this, no, it's not so easy to do that. It's highly exothermic reaction. So how you do the dilution, you take water, then put acid to dilute it to reduce the concentration. But do remember, the acid amount is same, it's just the water we are adding more. So amount of hydrogen ion, amount of hydrogen ion will always remain same while dilution. It just when I take a unit volume of the same solution, because if they're in higher volume, unit volume, maybe 1 ml will be having comparatively less hydrogen ion. So what will happen when I make an acid, dilute it, overall hydronium ion will not change because we are just putting water or solvent, not having hydrogen ion. But volume increased. So if you take the unit volume, now the same amount of hydronium ion is scattered in a larger volume. So when you take a unit volume, suppose 1 ml of the same, going to have less H ion. Okay, this is dilution. Adding solvent into your solute by putting solvent. That's it. Dipanshu, I'll do that. Okay. Amorphous is one of the type of solid only, Chinmay, which is comparatively weak in nature, and like you can break it easily, not having a proper order arrangement. Okay. So while you do dilution, what will you do, students? You will take water and then put acid so that you can control the heat that is going to generate. One idea, you can take ice bath. You can put crushed ice in a beaker, and then you can have your small beaker in which you can perform the dilution so that the heat evolved can be taken by the ice and not going to harm you. Okay? Yes? Amazing. Kiran, what happened? By seeing Ami? Okay, my Ami, yes. Hello, Ambika. Hello, Vishwa. What happened if weak acid is added? Vishwa, then also it's exothermic. But the amount of heat release will be comparatively less. When you take acetic acid and then you put it in water, then also heat release, but comparatively less. Strong acid, more heat release because they are so much corrosive. And now let's talk about the pH scale. This is a kind of indicator which is universal, because your normal indicator cannot tell us that how strong or weak your given acid or base is. Because now we know acid and base is not just acid and base, could be strong and weak. But we can't detect by normal indicators. pH is like, I am the winner. I will tell you how we'll make this universal indicator. We'll add so much of dyes and mix them together, and then that is so much sensitive towards the strength of acid and base, that every time with a weak acid, strong acid, weak base, strong base, neutral solution, it will give a different color. So that's how we can detect how strong or weak your given acid and base is. And with the help of that, we get a chart. And Sorensen in 1909 helped us a lot to understand that, that my value will vary from 0 to 14. And pH is like power of hydrogen, that on the basis of hydrogen ion, that my acid, even neutral and base will also having hydrogen ion. Because even whenever you take, your solution will contain water, because you're going to have water to have those H ion, OH ion free. And in water, H ion and OH ion is always there. So whenever you take solution, H ion and OH ion will always be there. It's just Sorensen who just took H ion into consideration. And he told that is inversely proportional to H ion concentration. More and more H ion, less and less will be the pH. And at pH 7, which is in between H ion and OH ion, is equal. Okay? And you can remember these three things. Just remember these three things. H ion and pH is inversely proportional. OH ion and pH ion is directly proportional. So lesser and lesser pH means more and more H ions. More and more H ion means stronger your acid is. So left side, stronger acid. Here, weaker acid, 7, neutral solution, green color. Right side, more and more OH, more and more pH. So basic solution, weak base, strong base. How to remember these color? Remember Vibgyor. Violet, indigo is like not something to include. Violet, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. Remember Vibgyor, that will help you to understand this better. Yes? Some background on green screen, Sarthak, in between I can't do that. In OBS, we have to put a chroma key, select chroma key, that I didn't do because something got, you know, not so visible. So I just removed it, but I'll use it next time. Concept of pH in day-to-day life. Yes. Will you marry me? Okay, I'm getting marriage proposal in between my live class. My students, please, this is not a good platform to ask me about getting married. Yes, I am doing a very good job teaching my students, making them the future of our society. Let's just stick to that. All right. Importance of pH is exactly what, students. pH is something that plays a very important role in our digestive system, even in our whole body. Our body works well in a pH of 7.2 to 7.4. Okay. So whenever our body's pH is going to get you know, on the lesser side, our body turns acidic, then only we get so much of disease. Okay? In acidic condition, we get so much of disease. So do remember that. And then doctor will give you some of the multivitamins and tablets to maintain that, because you must be having some deficiency of some, maybe iron, maybe other vitamins and all. And sometimes that happens when we try eating fast food and so much of sweet. Our bacteria in our body works in such a way, they releases acid to digest those particles. Okay, and during that digestion, so much amount of acid is released that our mucus layer starts hurting a lot. Ah, ouch, I got stomach pain. That happened because, you know, you are the responsible for the same. Achhe se khana tha, dekhe khana tha. You must have thought that what you are eating and eating in a proper manner, how much you can, you know, bear. And then excess of acid release, then what will happen? You have to maintain the pH by taking some base. And you take milk of magnesia, you take ENO, that is some example. These are the antacid. ENO is also having baking soda. So these are some solution. They react with the excess of acid and neutralize it. And then we'll be like, now I'm feeling better. Yes, like butterfly. All right. Tooth decay will be one more example how tooth got decayed. You just don't do brush at the night and you sleep off after eating. So bacteria will work in the mouth and saliva. And then, you know, to degrade small particles of the food, they releases acid. And as soon as pH goes below 5.5, that harms your teeth and start decaying. So please, a suggestion, you have to neutralize it with the base. Drink plenty of water before sleeping. Don't forget to brush, because that has bases and that neutralizes the acid. Yes, regularly doing brush. Very good. Keep it up. That is something that plays a role in soil health also and plant growth, because that's what farmers do. If they find that their soil is too acidic, they might not get the proper amount of crops on the same. So some of the bases like calcium oxide, calcium carbonate, weak bases to neutralize the acidity, to maintain the pH. So maintaining pH is very much important, my students. Very much important. Got it? And students, let me just tell you before moving ahead that Vedantu is a platform where you can get 100% knowledge and can get very good score. You're like, ma'am, why right now? Because right now also you're having 2 months where you can plan strategically that you can still master those topic which is still making you worry so much. And in each and every session, it's not just a class, but you'll be able to see so many sessions with our own feedback that these are the topic that you need to pay more and more attention. You can have high level quizzes also, because each and every topic after completion of that, we take quizzes to make sure that you get everything. And you can compete with the students throughout the world in a healthy competition. You can have interactive replay. It's like not replay will be bored, you'll be sitting and like wondering what happened. Interactive replay means in the replay mode also, you can have quizzes and come to leaderboard, which was not happening anywhere, students. Coming to leaderboard in a recorded session. But this is definitely a possibility. Okay, you'll be able to get all the notes with our own feedback. These are the questions. This is important. These are the questions that will help you to score better. These are the feedback which we can give so that you can do the smart work. And each and every doubt will get solved here. It's still not so possible, but in each and every class over there, each and every doubts will get solved. Okay, because not only master teachers, a team of class teachers will always assist you to solve your doubts. And with the help of so much of courses, like plenty of courses, crash courses, you can revise well right now with a 20% discount. You will get so much of things, students, not one, not two. And I'm assuring you, this will really boost your confidence and your score as well, because you will be able to revise with so much of crash courses. But don't forget to apply AGE Pro code because that will give you that additional 20% discount. How to do that? There's a link in the description box, the very first message pinned by Vedantu in the chat section also. And when you open it, you have to select CBSE 2021 as your target. And the course right now is at a very minimum price, that is just 1500. But if you apply AGE Pro code, the same course will be in 1200. Isn't it amazing? Just 1200 for a month and all your queries will be sorted. Yes, so you will get a session in as low as 6 rupees, the price that will not even give you a chocolate. yes Nadia, thank you so much Nadia. What exactly was that question, Atomic? Like, you can ask anything. Just because session is lagging. Is this the reason that, ma'am, it looks like something is happening with you? So do remember AGE Pro. Okay, let's talk about the salt portion now, students. Let's talk about the salt portion. That when I talk about the salt, acid base done, its application done, salts are the one that is mostly crystalline in nature and soluble in water. And by putting them into water, they'll dissociate into ions and they can conduct electricity. Salt will come with variety of taste, like they'll be salty, they'll be sour, they'll be sweet, bitter, and umami also. like you know, mixed kind of a flavor they'll give you. Yes, what do we call it? Chatpata. Okay, so they come with a different flavor depending upon the pH of the salt. They can be neutral, they can be acidic, they can be basic. Okay, neutral salt means the one that's having a pH 7 and that is made up of a strong acid and strong base. Acidic salt is something that's having a pH less than 7, that's why that is acidic and made up of a strong acid and a weak base. And basic salt from weak acid and strong base, pH greater than 7 because strong base. Let me give you an example. If I've taken, suppose these two, like a strong base and a strong acid, it just show a DD reaction, double displacement. We got our salt and water, and that's a reversible reaction also. Just by knowing the nature that this is neutral or not, I can take the salt and put it into water. I can get my acid and base back. And by knowing the acid and base, by knowing that which one is strong, both are strong, which one is weak, we can decide whether the given acid is strong, weak, or neutral. Okay? That's a neutral salt. Let's take an example of acidic salt. I have taken ammonia, which is a weak base. I have taken acid HCl, which is a strong acid. And now I'm going to get ammonium chloride, which is my acidic salt. Why this is acidic salt? Because weak base, strong acid. Strong acid with weak base, always acidic salt. Yes, students? All right. Okay. Where I am? Newton's fourth law. COVID-19 is directly proportional to the educational history by Lucky Dunn. That was a very nice interpretation that you made. High five, Mitanshu. You remember this Nonu ma'am. And don't do this to me. Like always... doing this with my name. All right, so basic salt will be made up of a strong base and weak acid. I'm taking, suppose, carbonic acid, which we have in soft drink, weak acid, strong base. I got sodium carbonate, right? Na2CO3 and H2O. So this is my basic salt, because made up of strong base and weak acid, pH will be greater than 4. Yes, students, got it? All right, now, not done. Let's talk about my one of the very important substance called as sodium hydroxide, my alkali, with the help of which we can make some substance. And how to get that? My salt is the solution, because we are talking about salt. If we take brine solution, students, what is brine solution? My solution of sodium chloride with water. When I'm having brine solution and when you pass the electricity, this will dissociate to give what? H ion we have. We have OH in water and Na positive and Cl negative. So My Cl negative ion will move to anode. Anode attract anion. You get chlorine gas. My H positive ion will move towards cathode because cathode attract cation and give hydrogen gas. And I'm left with Na and OH, so NaOH solution will also be formed. So when electricity is passed through brine solution, I'm getting NaOH having plenty of uses, soap formation and all, chlorine gas and hydrogen gas as well. And this chlorine gas we can use to prepare bleaching powder too. Bleaching powder formula is calcium oxychloride. And how we get this chlorine? From the previous reaction, we can pass it from the driest lake line, which is calcium hydroxide. And what I'm going to get it, students? What I'm going to get it? CaOCl2. I got CaOCl2 with HOH, that is water. Okay? HOH, that is water. So I got my bleaching powder with water. And bleaching powder is a solid, white color solid. And it will show bleaching property. Means what? It can we can use it to bleach my linen, my paper. My wood is not a white color. We just bleach it to get white paper. And students, you can also say this is a source to store chlorine gas. Chlorine is a gas and not easy to store. Whenever you take calcium oxychloride and put it in water, reaction will be reversible. You will get your chlorine gas, and chlorine is a very good disinfectant and kills bacteria. So you use the bleaching powder and put it in water to kill bacteria. So it can be used in swimming pools also. Yes, students? Got it? Give me a quick thumbs up. I think we can achieve our target. I'm waiting for it. 300. Hello, Amu. Hello, how are you? So you know the important property of bleaching powder? Yes, students? Hello, Pratibha. How are you? Where are you guys? Let's talk about baking soda too. Baking soda is sodium hydrogen carbonate, a basic salt. And how we can prepare that? By a process called as Solvay's process. When we are taking the brine solution, it's written brain. Brain solution. Brine solution and passing two gases, carbon dioxide gas and ammonia gas. When you pass these two gases, you know, ammonia always like hydrogen and chlorine. Okay. So like taking one hydrogen from here and one chlorine from here will get ammonium chloride. NH3, H, NH4 and Cl is gone. I am left with Na, one hydrogen and one carbon and three oxygen. So I'm getting NaHCO3. This is my baking soda. So by this process, I can get my baking soda. And the uses of baking soda, you know it. That this is a one fine powdered crystalline, partially soluble in water. And this is something we use in fire extinguisher because this will decompose to give CO2 gas and can help to extinguish the fire. This we use to prepare baking powder too. Baking powder is a mixture of baking soda with a weak organic acid like tartaric acid that will make the taste of the food pleasant only, not going to make it bitter. Because if you put baking soda directly in food, it gives washing soda that can give a bitter taste. So that's how. And that is a good antacid also, right? Baking soda is something, if nothing is there at home, you can take your baking soda and put it in water. Antacid. You get your antacid, baking powder, you use it in toothpaste also. Try paste, you will find it written that sodium hydrogen carbonate, which is your sodium hydrogen carbonate, which is your baking soda. Yes, students? Tell me quickly. Understood? All right. Wonderful. Joseph, I do remember you. Okay. Raghav, wonderful. Let's talk about washing soda. This is a very important question that can come into exam. How to prepare washing soda from baking soda? So you know how to prepare baking soda? We took my brine solution and passed CO2 gas and ammonia gas. We got baking soda. We are going to heat it and then it will give, you know, salt, water and CO2. I got my salt, sodium carbonate, but this is anhydrous salt. Anhydrous means this is the one not going to have any property of washing soda. This is just soda ash. When you take it and put water, it will show water of crystallization. Some water molecule will attach to it. This is my washing soda. sodium carbonate with 10 molecule of water. Get it, students? Sodium carbonate with 10 molecule of water is washing soda that helps for the cleansing property. This is very much important. Remove permanent hardness of water. Glass industry, glass is made from a substance, borax. And borax is something that we can prepare from sodium carbonate. Na2B4O7.10H2O. Okay? So, washing soda is having plenty of uses, particularly talking about Na2CO3 sodium carbonate inside it. And this one is very interesting, and you know, so many times I can relate to it, and that is our POP. What do you say about POP, students? Pop, not the pop sound. POP is the one where do you use it? When we have gypsum that we get from Paris, that's why plaster of Paris. We got it initially from Paris only. We took our gypsum and we heat it around 100 degrees Celsius. Then we got our POP. Okay, so this is calcium sulfate with 2 molecule of water. When you heat it around 373 Kelvin, the temperature is very much important, because then only half molecule of water retained by this and 3/2 molecule of water is evaporated. This is POP. Okay, this is POP. And this is a very important question that came into exam, that when you have POP, you can't put it, you cannot keep it outside. You should put it into some airproof container. The reason with the same is, when plaster of Paris come in the contact of air, it will trap the moisture. Moisture ka matlab kuch water molecule ko trap kar legi and will give you the gypsum back, and it will convert to hard mass, and it will not show the same property that POP was showing. जैसे फॉल्स सीलिंग को डिजाइन करने में पीओपी को हम प्लास्टर को हम यूज करते हैं ना ऐसे और प्लास्टर लगा देते हैं, दैट विल बी सेट एज हार्ड मास, योर बोन विल नॉट यू नो मूविंग एंड कैन सेटल एट द सेम पोजिशन, सो दैट विल एक्ट एज अ प्लास्टर बाय पुट मिक्सिंग विद वाटर एंड अप्लाई. बट अगर आपने ऐसे ही छोड़ दिया, अल्टीमेटली इट विल एब्जॉर्ब एंड गिव यू जिप्सम एंड कन्वर्ट टू हार्ड मास. ठीक है, यस, यू गॉट इट. One question is there from students that, ma'am, when we use nitric acid, we didn't get the same result. So, aisa isliye hota hai, students, metal with acid, not with nitric acid, kyunki ye ek better OA hai. OA ka matlab oxidizing agent. Oxidizing agent kya karta hai, students? Isko oxidize kar dega. To aapko metal salt milege, dekho isme bhi oxygen hai. Hydrogen gas milni chahiye thi, metal salt and hydrogen. ये ऑक्सीडाइज करके उसको वाटर में कन्वर्ट कर देगा और खुद अपने में से ऑक्सीजन को कम कर देगा, खुद रिड्यूस हो जाता है. सो नाइट्रिक एसिड इज अ बेटर ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट रादर देन जस्ट शोइंग द डिस्प्लेसमेंट रिएक्शन. यस डॉक्टर यूज टू मेक प्लास्टर. यस बच्चा अनूप सर, यू नो अनूप सर राइट, इन हिंदी चैनल, आई मीन इन इंग्लिश चैनल ही इज टीचिंग. इन जनवरी ही मेट विद एन एक्सीडेंट एंड गॉट अ फ्रैक्चर, यू नो बोन जस्ट पॉप आउट एंड ही गॉट अ फ्रैक्चर फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 2 to 3 मंथ्स. So yeah, and yep, so it will be like same for 2 to 3 months, then his bone got joined. So that is something that happened. Pratibha, so cute, can I call you cutie pie? You can call me cutie ma'am, that will work for me. Yes students, okay, so one last thing I wanted to tell you, that you have seen plenty of molecules where I'm putting some water molecule by a dot. What exactly is this? This is called as water off crystallization, when some of the fixed molecule of water is attached physically to a compound that will give a crystalline structure and sometime color also. So I had my copper sulfate with 5 molecule of water, which is called as blue vitriol, just because vitriol means glassy appearance, crystalline appearance, and blue color only came due to water off crystallization. When you heat it, water molecule is gone, it will be in the anhydrous form, and this is white. So the color is due to water of crystallization sometime, and so as the crystalline appearance. What is water of crystallization? A fixed molecule of water making a part of the structure and giving the color and crystalline appearance. Yes, my lappy is about to die, just try to refresh. No, just put it on charging. Refresh every time. It's just one thing that came to our mind. Refresh. Sana, I'm absolutely awesome. What about you? Yes, students. So with this, the revision of acid basis salt is done, Dunadan, in a thorough manner. Hope you got everything. Do let me know in the comment section. Curie, ma'am. But don't forget to check out all the courses of Vedantu. There is a link in the description box. One message will be pinned by Vedantu channel. The very first message you'll see in the comment section. Open select CBSE 10th class as your target. Choose your 1 to 2 months courses, but don't forget to apply AGE Pro code. You will get unlimited benefits over there, and it will really help you to score, better marks and build your personality and help in the proper revision. And each and every session will just cost you 6 rupees, which is lesser than a price of a chocolate. So avail this opportunity. Don't miss out. Come and attend all the sessions with all of the master teacher that you know. Yeah. And it is going to be an awesome journey. You can follow me on Instagram also. Finally, my Instagram ID is comparatively big, but you can see chemistry.vedantu, chemistry Vedantu underscore Anubhagar. Yep, students. So tell me, did you like the session? I'll wait for your comments in the comment section, because your comments are very much important. Okay, Tiwari ji, I am from Haryana. Thank you, Satya. So don't forget to like the video. I think we have crossed our target. That is very important. And don't forget to share it among your friends, because the language barrier is also solved. Because here on this channel, I'm teaching in particularly English. And you can subscribe to the channel if you're new. You can reach out to me on my email ID given. Yep. Maza aa gaya. That's so awesome to know. So awesome to know. So students, I'm going to meet you next time. Very soon, again live with one more mind map session. And until then, keep following, stay tuned, please take care of yourself, be in a good health, and take care. Until then, take care. Bye bye. See ya. Hasta la vista.